Hey guys, welcome to Riva Academy, and in this tutorial we are going to look at different kinds of buttons in Flutter. So if you like this video, please share it with your friends who are also learning Flutter. So we started by creating a new project in Visual Studio Code. Okay, and I will remove these two extra classes. Okay, and also remove this title parameter so that we can start with a clean slate. I have created a new class by the same name, My Home Page. Okay, and instead of container, this will return a scaffold, and I will quickly add the app bar. Okay, and inside the app bar, I will add the title text. Okay, say buttons demo. Okay, and I will run in emulator. So you can see that this is nicely running in emulator. Okay, then we will start by adding the body. Okay, and in this body we will add column so that we can place the buttons one below each other. Okay, so I have added this children parameter. Okay, so I will start by adding a simple raised button. Okay, so this will take an on pressed. Okay, so right now I will keep it as a null. Okay, now when I save and hot reload, you can see a blank button appearing on the screen. Okay, right now this is a disable button. I will explain you why. Okay, now let us add for some text over here, and I will say this as a disable button. This is a disable button because inside the on press we have written null. Okay, now you can see this text appearing over here. Okay, you can style this text by adding style. Okay, text style. Okay, and I will increase the font size to say 20. Okay, when I save and hot reload, you can see that this the text has been changed. Okay, now this button is disabled because on press we have written null. Okay, now let me quickly create one more button so that you can see the difference. Okay, over here instead of null, I will just return a blank function. Okay, so now when I save and hot reload, you can see that this button is no more a disabled button. Okay, so let me write over here raised button. Okay, so when even you click, this is clickable while the disabled button is not clickable, right? So this is the difference. Okay, in the disabled button the on pressed is null. Okay, and in the non-disable button, in on press we have defined a function. Okay, so this is how you create disable buttons and non-disable buttons in Flutter. Okay, so these are the simplest form of the button. Now you can customize this button as per your project requirements. Okay, now first let me format this column. Okay, so this displays properly. Okay, and I will also add some padding. Okay, okay, so now these buttons are displaying nicely. Okay, now you can put some colors also in this button. Let me put, okay, using colors parameter, and you can also change the color of your text. Okay, so you can customize the text like this, and if you want, you can also add some padding. Okay, when you save and hot reload, you can see now this padding has been added. Okay, now we will see one more property of the raised button, that is elevation. Okay, so we can add this property by elevation, and you can give a number to this, let's say 20. Okay, so when we save and hot reload, you can see that some shadow has been added. Okay, let me remove it. So now you can see the difference. When there is no elevation, it appears as a flat button. Okay, so now let me do one thing. I will copy paste the same button so that you can see the difference. Okay, in one I will add elevation and in another one I will remove it. Okay, now let me change the text also to say elevated button. Okay, now you can see the difference. If the button, if this elevation property is added, this is slightly, you can see the shadow in the bottom, whereas if there is no elevation, it is just like a flat button. Okay, you can let me change the color also, say red. Okay, so hope you got the difference between the elevated button and when there is no elevation property. Okay. Okay, now let us see some more. I will copy the same button one more time. Okay. And let me add some shape property to this. Okay, let us create one circular button. Okay, to that I have added the shape property and circle border. Okay, now you can see that this button has been created. Okay, this circle button has been created, but the text is very long. Let us fix this first. I will change the color. You can see this button is also clickable. Okay, now let me increase some padding, let's say 50. Okay, now you can see the size of the button has been increased to fill in the text. Okay, and let me change the text to say circular button. Okay, and I will remove these font size from here so that text appears bit smaller. Okay, now you can see that this circular button has been created, and when you click on it, the material effect is also been seen. Okay, so it is very easy to create a circular button in Flutter. You just have to set the shape property to circle border. Okay, now let us create one more. Okay, so you can customize these buttons as per your project requirements. Okay, so I have just copy pasted the above button, and let us make the corners of this button round. Okay, first I will change the color of this button to blue, and I will say rounded button. Okay, so let us change the corner of this button, and to do so we have to again go to the shape property. Okay, add rounded rectangle border and specify the value of the border radius. Okay, border radius dot circular and say 10. Okay, so when you do that, you can see the corners are rounded. Okay, now what if I want the whole opposite sides of the button to be round? Okay, so what I will do is I will let me copy paste the button again. Okay, so we will see that also when the whole opposite sides are round. Okay. Okay, I've copy pasted this button over here, and let me say this also as a round button, or just round button. Okay, and change the color to orange. Okay, now when I save and hot reload, you can see. Now let us go back to the shape property, and over here there is a property called stadium border. Okay, so when you give that save and hot reload, you can see the opposite sides of the button has become round. Okay, so there are so many properties to explore. You can do that. Okay, and make the buttons as per your project requirements. Okay, now let us try some more. Okay, so I have copy pasted this button, and let us try outline border. Okay, so inside the shape there is this property outline input border. Okay, so when you save and hot reload, let me change the color to pink. Okay, you can see outline button. Okay, the outline has been added. Let me make it light color, say amber. Okay, so you can see the outline button has been created. Okay, so there are so many properties inside the shape where you can customize it as per your requirements. Okay, you can just play around and customize them. Okay, now you can also create your own custom shapes. Okay, let me show you one example. Say custom shape button. Okay, and inside the shape property, okay, let me remove shape. Okay, save and hot reload. There is some issue. Okay, so let us fix that first. So what we will do, we will go to our body parameter and we will add some we will add a list view. Okay, we will wrap this up with a list view so that a scrolling is provided. Okay, so let me wrap this with a list view. Okay, so when you save and hot reload, there is an auto scroll now provided. Okay, so now coming back to our custom shape button. Okay, now okay, let me change this to red. Okay, now let us customize the shape for this button. Okay, so do so. Let us go back to the shape parameter and say rounded rectangle border. Okay, border radius. Border radius dot only. Okay. We will just customize one corner first, say top left. Okay, say radius dot circular. Say 20. Okay, when I save and hot reload, you can see the top left border, okay, has been it's in circular shape. Okay, if you want, you can add one more over here, say top right also we will add. Okay, let us add this border radius to top right also. Okay, when you save and hot reload, you can see. Okay, so you can customize the shape of this button as per your requirements. Okay, you can do it opposite ends also like this. Okay, top left and bottom right. Okay, so this creates kind of a custom shape. You can play around with other properties also. Okay, cool. What else? Okay, now let us make a gradient button. Okay, so let us start by adding one more button over here. Okay, let me set on press to a blank function. Okay, and then I will add the child text. Okay, say gradient. Okay, now when I save and hot reload, you can see a simple button. And now we will add the gradient to this. Okay, to do so, first let me change the font size of this. Okay, say text style font size to say 20. Okay, now wrap this text with a container. Okay, so what I will do is wrap this with a container. Okay, let me format the document. Okay, so over here inside the container there is this decoration parameter. Okay, decoration, box decoration, and there is this gradient parameter. We will add this linear gradient. Okay, and specify the array of the colors inside the linear gradient. Okay, whichever colors you want for your gradient to appear, you can specify multiple colors over here. Okay, so for example, let's say red and colors dot say colors dot blue. Okay, so I have specified two colors, red and blue gray. Okay, now you can see this gradient effect over here. Okay, now let me set the padding to this button so that this button becomes bigger. Okay, say 20. Okay, right? So I have specified like two colors. If you want, you can specify three colors as well. Okay, so let me add pink also. So this has created this linear gradient effect by the colors which we have specified. Okay, you can also control the text color by over here, text color colors dot white. Okay, now let us fix that padding issue. So what we will do is, in the raised button, padding we will set to 0. Okay, so now you can see how we created this gradient button as well. Okay, so you can create different kind of buttons as per your requirements. Okay, now let me put this size box between this gradient button and circular button because they are overlapping. Okay, so hope you like this video, and if you really did, please share it with your friends who are also learning Flutter. Thank you so much for watching.